Hello my boys, we're still in Krangle event and I want to show you another explosive arrow ballista setup. This one is very interesting for two reasons. I will show you the ascendancy points and my item setup. As you can see, I'm above level 90. I'm having fun with this. I think this is the tankiest of all. Every time I create a new one, I said this is the best, this is the best. Because I have better items. You know, the first character you started in Krangle was very hard. But once you get your items, it becomes easier, much more easy. I will show you the items first, let's start somewhere, and what I did. Okay, so here is what I did. I crafted this quiver, which bow attacks fire an additional arrow, which is useful. Also has a lot of life, because I struggled with life. Look at my life bar. This gives me close to 1000 life, helps me to sustain, so to remain alive in maps. It's very useful, so I use this, a widow hail. So I will settle with this one. Also gives me more damage with bows, more life, more free arrows. Elemental damage it attacks is just great, you know. If you're wondering, for explosive arrow ballista, you always want attack speed. Very important. But I get a lot of attack speed because I have onslaught and onslaught effects on the skill tree here. So here onslaught effect. I also have a small one, I think here with onslaught effect. Yeah, as you can see. And here on the ascendancy, I get a lot of attack speed from here. Attack speed per frenzy charge. And I have 4 frenzy charges because I also have this one here, which gives me additional frenzy charge, which I get a lot of attack speed, so I don't miss on damage. As a matter of fact, I'll do a map showcase tier 16, so you can see the damage for this, which is great. This is very tanky, good damage, I'm very happy. But also I have good items. Look here, 6 link, the rest of defiance, the taming, Diadin's down. Again, first character is the hardest. After it gets easy and easy. I want to show you something for elementalist. Here you have Bastion of Elements, which is another shield that absorbs elemental damage, which replenishes. So if I take spell damage and this goes off, in 5 seconds, 10 seconds, I will have it up again. You will see it in the map showcase. Enough talking, boys, I talked a lot. Now let's open a tier 16 map, because why not? I'm gonna juice it just with quality, because I'll go for 95. See, I'll try go for 95 with this one. I'm having a blast, if I'm gonna tell you, I'm having a blast. Also, look at my Atlas setup here. Not only I took the Blighted Nodes, but I also took this Nico Pact with Energy. I'm forcing it by putting a Scarab, you know? Helps. This helps a lot. Okay, let's start and see the damage. Okay, so for the next event, Sentinel, which will start very soon, I will make a separate guide. Because this is Krangle event, it's a mess. Half of these skill points are useless, you know? Krangle event will be gone and hope it will be gone forever. But for the normal Atlas progression, I will make a separate video, maybe tomorrow, so you can see for Sentinel how to do it. I told you go Raider or Champion, but I will repeat the best route possible to get it, and you will enjoy it. If I'm doing so much damage with in Krangle, imagine how much damage you do in normal. This is tier 16 in Krangle, which is very hard. Yeah, I repeat, half of my passive nodes are useless. But I'm managing it. Look, it's very easy. Look at my life bar. I don't struggle. I'm also using Delirium. Monsters are harder. Okay, I'll cut Delirium. And Sarcassia. Oh, this is great. Oh, this is also great. Yeah, idea is, in this event you want to rush the Atlas to get to red maps. Because on red maps you get the best loot. Okay? So, boys, in the next event, just focus on locking your Atlas here or doing maps. The faster you reach red maps, the richer you become. Okay. Also, focus Blight and take this Keystone here, which is Cassia's Pride. This will make the towers do shit ton of damage. Look, they're killing everything for me. Yeah, this is nuts. All you have to do is to build towers and... Look, I won't attack. I won't attack, I'll stay here. Look at the damage from the towers. You can also put this ring anoints, so scout towers have more range. I love scout towers, they are very overpowered. So they have huge range because of this anoint. Your scout towers have 21% increased range. So Blight gives you a lot of currency in terms of oil and zone oil extractors and a lot of experience. But now, because I'm level 91, it's much harder to get experience. But at lower levels, I get shit ton of experience. That's how I leveled up so fast. Yeah, very easy, very easy. So in the next events, try to go for Blight. Okay, let's loot this. Okay, so we got free. And by the way, this sell very good, okay? So this I can sell for 50 kilos. I sold shit ton of them. Because they are red tier 14, 16, sell very good in this event. And look how many I get. I'm making money everywhere, I have to manage money. So in the next event, try to listen to what I said and go for Blight, boys. Go for Blight. Follow my upcoming build guide for Sentinel event and go for Blight and you will make a lot of money. A lot of money. Oh, we have also... Let's complete the rituals, why not? You need to move a lot because sometimes you also have those meteors that can one-shot you, you know? I don't have Chaos Resistance. Here is another tip. Look, I play with my map opened so I can see the items when they drop on the minimap. So I fast navigate the minimap. I'm not looking at this, only at the map I'm looking, not at the monsters. Maybe you want to do this also. Okay, here it is. So moving a lot, it's a natural defense. You know, that's why you move a lot. New players tend to stay in one place and that's a horrible idea. Horrible idea. I'll take this. Okay, let's kill the boss. I'm really enjoying this because it feels very safe. Because of the elemental Aegis here, also I have good defenses. Look. 80 chance to evade attacks, good physical damage reduction, good resistances. This is great. Yeah, I love it. Pa-ra-pa-pa-pa. Okay, let's kill the boss. No! Oh! For tier 16, this is good damage, you know? The trade is also bad and I cannot buy items, you know, for my upgrades. So, yeah, this is good damage. Okay. Let's do another map. I'm really enjoying this. So far, what I can say. So, I struggled. The first selector was very hard in Krangle, but once you get your items, everything becomes easy. But try to listen to what I said. Try to move a lot. Okay, so you want to move a lot. Let's do a Blighted map, yeah? So, if you're wondering how I got to this level very fast, I did Blighted maps. As a matter of fact, if you go here, you can see I have a bunch of them. Each of these maps sells for 50 kilos, 80 kilos, so I can make shit ton of money, but I already have a lot. I don't care anymore. Yeah. Yeah, let's put this here. Okay, let's do a black. I'll show you how I do them. Okay, maybe you're curious how I use them. You want some quality because we want to get some loot. I put this and I roll with alteration. You know, this is for the loot. Usually I also care about the loot. Something harmless. This is harmless. I don't care about this. Now, you want to go to the oil tab and you put like this. 2 amber and 1 verdant. Verdant gives more experience. 2 ambers reduces the cost of the towers. And now we're gonna open it and then we will do full blighted map. This is tier 15, okay? Some struggle even in league. Okay, this is Krangle event. It's even harder. But I will show you how I do it. I have multiple videos on this, but I will repeat for you now. Okay, boys. First thing first, you put the portal farther away so you don't click it by mistake. Now you look at the immunities. I like minion towers and we have just 2 immunities here. We don't have freeze tower immunity, which is great. So I put here a freeze tower level 3. And I'm gonna focus on minion towers, so let's put it here. Scout tower. This is the best tower in game, by the way. Okay, I think I'll shut up so you can see the gameplay. Maybe I put some music now and we see the loot at the end. Yeah, let's go. Okay, now we clear everything and we loot. If you notice, if I have immunities, I make multiple towers. So I didn't went just for scout towers because I had 2 scout immunities. I also make meteor towers. So you need to diversify. You focus on one tower type, which for, in this scenario was scout tower, but you want to make other types also. Just remember to put at the intersection freeze towers, these ones. Yeah? If they have freeze immunity, put stun towers. Stun towers are these ones, okay? This helps, okay? So at the intersection, you put either freeze tower or stun tower. If you have both immunities, you will put freeze tower and stun tower close to each other, okay? And you upgrade it to level 3. Yeah. And the monster will stay in place. Very easy. That is the last monsters. I'm pretty sure this is the last one. Come on, die. Good. Now you start looting, you know? Which, by the way, because this is red blighted map, you will get great loot. Good loot. I already heard that sound. I think it's at the pump. Let's go check it, see what we got. Divinal, yeah? Of course. Yeah, and you make good experience. As you can see, I almost got 2.5 bars, which is a lot for level 91. You get good loot that you can sell. Let's check the rolls. Not bad. This has good rolls. Yeah, I'll put this for two divines. So in this event, if you go blight, you can't miss it. You always make profit. People need oils for the amulets. It's great. So much money. So much money. Yeah. You know, I'm lazy to list everything for sale, but keep in mind for the upcoming events, you will go blight and you want explosive arrow because it's just broken, you know? These events last for a short period of time, so you don't want to make an elaborate build, you know? You just put the dial dance down and the quill rain and you will destroy everything, yeah? Ah, boys, okay, so good idea. Let's take a closer look first at the skill tree. This tree is very similar to my last one, when I did a Hierophant, one moment, video yesterday. I made for the Trickster, for the Hierophant, now I will upload for the Elementalist. I really enjoyed, now I'm having fun because I have good items. Here is the big trick that I did, I used Widow Hail, which gives me almost triple bonuses from this quiver, you know. You can get with better roll, but I think it's expensive, let me check. Or none up. Yeah, I took the best one from the market. Boys, see you in the Sentinel event. Tomorrow I'll make a video with best tips for Sentinel, you know? How to have a great time there, okay? Talk later. Cheers!